This is the device used in this demo. This is a product called SenseCAP Indicator released by Seed Studio. As you can see, it is very solid. Unlike general development boards, it is a complete product equipped with a housing case. The peculiarity of this device is that it is equipped with two MCUs. ESP32S3 is the main controller and supports display and external connection via Wi-Fi. The RP2040 used as a subcontroller is responsible for the sensor. In order to access the data obtained from the sensor from the ESP32, communication with the RP2040 is required. Based on serial communication, data is sent and received using an algorithm that encodes data bytes called COBs. Please see the link below for more detail on this. In order for us to attach additional sensors to this device, we must use the I2C port on the back of this device. If you need to connect more external sensors to the microcontroller, this is probably not a good solution. Nonetheless, this device can be very helpful in studying the overall system flow, not only because of the hardware but also because the demo examples provided by this manufacturer are very good. For example, there's a lot of work we need to do to configure Home Assistant and connect with it. I think it's well worth it as a beginner because you can try this from start to end. All of this UI is being drawn using LVGL. It's also using Squareline Studio to compose its UI UX. It seems to be made very neatly. If you are interested in configuring UI UX for embedded using Squareline Studio, this is a great example. You can see not only how the screen is composed, but also how the UI and code are combined. Unfortunately, the Squareline Studio project for this entire project is not provided. I think it would have been nice if the manufacturer had shared the entire UI project as well. In this video, we will look at what is needed to connect to the Home Assistant configured with Raspberry Pi in the previous project. I think most of you probably don't have this device right now. Therefore, I will move on to the device-dependent parts after explaining them as quickly as possible. Please skip this part if you don't need it. I don't want to waste your time. ESPIDF version 5.0 is required to build this device example. The reason is that you need to set the SPI speed to 120 MHz for this device, which is not officially supported yet. The manufacturer has released a patchwork to modify the 5.0 version of IDF on its own, and ESPIDF version 5.0 is required to apply this. The patchwork file is available from their project GitHub. You can do this with Git apply. If there are no errors, it has been applied without problems. You can check the changes by looking at Git status. Okay, all looks good. The example I will use is an example called Indicator Ha. This is because all communication with the Home Assistant is implemented, so you can quickly test it. After applying the patchwork like this, you can change the flash SPI speed to 120 MHz and select the screen type. The system will not work without this. Without any changes, let's try this example. Looking at the console log here, it says that the MQTT connection is refused. Why? When we registered a new user in the previous video, we set a password for the MQTT indicator. Because this part is not correct, update via MQTT is not possible. Let's fix this part. Open the indicate.hac file in the model folder. You can see there is the MQTT credential password set on line number 311. Since I set the Home Assistant's MQTT user's password to 1234, I will set it the same. Let's check it again. The console log doesn't seem to find any issues this time. Are you seeing the value change in the browser on the left? It is publishing the sensor values to my HA without any issues. It's working perfectly. Not only does the sensor data update while communicating with my Home Assistant server, but you can see that the UI is also perfectly synced. It works simply, but the UI code and structured code make it very difficult to read the core workflow. If it is a real commercial project, it is easy to update and maintain the system by dividing it into model, view, and controller as in this example, and implementing each corresponding part. This is a great example if you want to build a structured system. I can't see this in full with you guys, so I've prepared a very simple example of communicating with HA. We already prepared our own home assistant in the previous video. I'll show how an ESP32 connects to this HA server and publishes and subscribes to data over MQTT to a specific topic. I prepared it in advance so that you can see only the source code for the part that communicates with our HA server through MQTT on ESP32. This works on all ESP32 series, and only if you have your own home assistant running like in this previous video. Currently, I'm using the ESP32S3 DevKit C. As you can see, the source code is very simple. Since the sensor is not connected, information on temperature, humidity, CO2, and indoor air quality is updated with dummy data every 3 seconds. After connecting to Wi-Fi, it tries to connect to Home Assistant's MQTT server. Unfortunately, the MQTT broker's URL must use the local IP address. So, I directly entered the local IP address of the HA server. The MQTT client library I use doesn't seem to be able to use .local. We also need credentials to connect to the MQTT broker. Set the username and password as above. This is a very simple code and can be useful in an environment that does not require a UI. Let's build it and see how it works. HA's dashboard is being updated with dummy data from the ESP32. If you have a sensor you want, you can attach it and use it the same way. Looking at the workflow for updating the HA dashboard, ESP32 makes temperature data in JSON type and transmits it to MQTT inside the HA with the keyword indicator sensor. In the HA system, the value obtained from MQTT is put into specific entities, and the value is updated. Finally, design how to display values for each entity in the dashboard. These three components are essential for HA to communicate perfectly with your microcontroller. Conversely, you can also send certain events from the dashboard to the microcontroller. Turning a switch on or off or sending a specific value is no problem. I was able to configure Home Assistant based on a Raspberry Pi and update bidirectional data via MQTT with a microcontroller. Based on this, I think there are many projects we can do. First, you can connect the ESP32 CAM to shoot inside and outside your home. It can be operated in a similar way to an IP camera. You can also check real-time data by attaching sensors that you always want to check to the microcontroller. This Home Assistant supports mobile apps, so you can check sensor data in the same way very easily. If I get a chance, I will try to do more projects based on this Home Assistant. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.